I will start my presentation. Good afternoon from Italy and good evening from Indonesia. Hello, ladies and gentlemen. I would like to thanks to MedFrag2 to given me to presentation our paper. Now, I will introduce myself. My name is Erika Dwayusya Putri, and I'm under supervisor from Triyono and Mr. Aditya Rio Prabowo from Department Mechanical Engineering Universitas 11 Maret Indonesia. I will to talking about estimating failure mechanism of steel specimen using stress corrosion cracking testing method state and development. Now, this is my outlining. The first is about introduction. The second is stress corrosion cracking. The third is stress corrosion cracking testing methods. And the last is conclusion. Now, what is the problem from this picture? Yeah, the problem from this picture is corrosion. What is the corrosion? Corrosion is the phenomenon of damage experienced by the metal materials usually as a result of the interacting with the surrounding environment. Nah, this corrosion can cause the dangerous and expensive damage to everything. There are time profile to methods to present and control corrosion that can reduce the estimate its impact and the environment, economic losses, and the harm human life. Nah, a report about total direction cost of corrosion from NACE International 2016 report show that the $276 billion per year or 3.1% gross domestic product at the times. It means that the cost for each person per year was approximately $970. Many investigation and research study have the correct at to treat the corrosion that occur in structural failure. However, this problem is still difficult to be controlled. So, this topic from this presentation about the corrosion. There are many types of the corrosion, but in this presentation, I will to talking about the SCC. SCC or stress corrosion cracking. Nah, stress corrosion cracking is the phenomenon of cracking in the material that occur when the tensile stress, corrosion environment, and susceptible the material exist at the same time. SCC can occur when the material has the crack is directly related to mechanical stress, environment, and metals properties. If the propagation of the cracks on the materials and the combine the three conditions, so the SCC will be simultaneously. So it is a serious problem in the industrial and the in the land of the oil and gas. Nah, there are three parameters of the SCC. The first is material, the second is tensile, and the third is environment. Materials is the required acceleration by increasing the severity of the environment or the critical test parameter. SCC behavior could be measured using the mechanical properties of the material and in the air or the corrosive environment, such as elongation, reduction in area, and ultimate tensile strength to accurately predict the strength and the failure of the structure. Nah, this is one of the papers about one of the research about the SCC. There are crack propagation. Nah, this is crack propagation in the surface. And the, on the metallography, we can see the crack propagation in the surface of the metallography analysis. So it is very dangerous for the industrial application. Nah, this is a step our schematic of SCC. The first is about the crack initiation sites and the interaction between the stress field and enabling cracks influence the crack growth rate. And the second phase is the characteristic by sustainably small crack nucleation and the second cracks. And the last phase is the crack growth is very rapid and unstable and it's make the materials is failure. Nah, this is the SCC testing methods of the material. The first is
We don't hear you. Sorry?
You bending?
Okay. Now we listen to you. Okay.
Yeah, I'm sorry. What happened, mister?
It's okay.
Okay.
You can continue.
I will. Okay. Okay. The first is you bending specimen. You bending specimen has been the widely applied in the qualitative assessment of the SAC resistance of the differential alloy in the different corrosive media. U-bending specimen testing method can be used the ASTM D30 standard practice. Nah, from this method is widely used because it can produce many specimens and it is suitable for the assessment of alloy and heat treatment susceptible to stress corrosion cracking. Nah, this question is applied strain in the U-bending specimen. Epsilon equal T divided to R when T less than R. What is the T? T is about the thickness. R is a radius of the curve the specimen. So when the U-bending specimen is formed, the material in the outer fibers of the bending, so the plastic portion to true stress and true strain curve. Now, the second is shearing specimen. Shearing specimen is the spring that provide tension on the bolt or device. Now, shearing specimen, they are measured using the coordinate measure. And the ASTM from this this testing is about the G3801 standard. And there are the equation for the stress in the shearing specimen. Now, DF equal D minus delta. Delta equal tau D squared divided for ETZ. When the D is about the diameter from this specimen, the F are about outer, the diameter, outer. Nah, and the tau is elastic stress, and delta is the required stress. So the third is tensile specimen. The STM from this testing is about the G46 standard. Nah, tensile specimen measure tensile properties in the air and adapted the stress corrosion cracking testing method. This testing can be subject to be a wide range of the stress level associated with the elastic of plastic strain. And the tensile specimen that include machine notes to be analysis stress corrosion cracking and hydrogen embedment. And the last is slow strain rate testing. It's the testing conduct the corrosive specimen in the air to produce the SCC susceptible in ICC. And this equation from ICC is ELGLY minus ELSCC divides ALGLE.
Sorry, you have all 2 minutes.
Oh, yeah. And yeah. The divides 100. And the last in conclusion, the stress corrosion cracking is the one of the main cause of the structural in the industry. And there are 3 parameters. There are materials, tensile stress, and corrosive environment. The testing method from this SEC, there are 3. The first is U-bending specimen, shearing specimen, tensile specimen, and SSRT. The results show the behavior of SEC based on mechanical properties and the material, and the corrosive media, and the air, such as elongation to failure, reduction in area, and ultimate tensile strength to accurately predict the strength and failure of the material. And this method is very important to do to testing. Okay, thank you.